Seeing the CPUs I'm going to compare, you'll probably think I'm nuts. But the thing is that I recently built a PC for video editing and 4K gaming. But the local experts from the comments section quickly explained to me where I was wrong and said that 13500 would be a massive bottleneck for my RTX 4090 even at 4K. Intel marketing department and those who listen to them so persistently advises at least i7 for games. So I listened to them and picked the i9-14900K as the best CPU for gaming from Intel. And let's compare them! No mercy to my i5-13500. If we compare them in artificial condition at 720p, of course 14900K wins. But if you buy high-end components, I don't think that you're gonna play at 720p monitor. High refresh Full HD? Maybe, but I doubt it. 1440p high refresh rate monitor? Possibly. But ultra-wide? Or 4K, most realistic scenario. And since I've been told that even at 4K there will be a serious bottleneck, that's exactly what I wanna check. I know that usually CPUs are tested in other conditions, but trust me, even in this comparison there will be unexpected results. Also, we will test some multiplayer games in 1440p. I didn't do any overclocking, simply connected CPU and run tests, and the rest of the PC specs you can see on the screen. All the benchmarks was performed on Ultra Graphics preset with DLSS quality if it's supported. At first glance the result was the same, but as soon as I started shooting, 1% low on 14900K dropped to 34 FPS. Another game where 1% low is better on the 13500, but the average FPS is better on the 14900K. In Atomic Heart the average FPS keeps about the same. But 1% low is better on 14900K this time. Again the difference in 1% low in favor of 13500. And the result was frame generation. This time they got the same 1% low. In Days Gone the 14900K shows 5% better result in average FPS and a more stable 1% low. And finally, in God of War we see the superiority of 14900K, as long as you need 150 FPS in single player game. ...14900K repeats the better result again. Nice recommendation, by the way. In Spider-Man, the 14900K also shows better performance by 20-30%. But personally, I'm not ashamed to turn on the frame generation in single-player games. This way I can level out the disadvantage of my CPU. And in Red Dead Redemption 2, for some reason, 13500 constantly showing a better result. I repeated the same benchmarks for a few times, and the result was the same. Time to switch to multiplayer games. In the finals we see around 10% worse performance on the 13500 and less stable FPS. But actually this game is very CPU dependent, and it's a great example of how other games can theoretically behave at lower resolution. Once I changed the resolution to 1440p, the performance gap can raise up to 60%, or maybe this game is just not optimized yet. In CS2 there was no difference at all. And same with Apex Legends. It's time to see the final results. So, do you see a significant advantage for 14900K? Of course you can still overclock it and the result would be even better, and your home will get even warmer in the winter. But the main question is how much FPS do you need for single player games? For me 100 is already a good result, and anything above 120 is not important. After all, my monitor cannot show more than that. In some multiplayer games situation is different. Games like The Finals and most likely the Battlefield 2042 will require a high performance CPU. So buying a CPU like i7 may be more justified here. But in other cases, I consider it a waste of money. Sorry, but I do believe that 14900K is overkill for gaming. Look at the percentage of utilization. Do you really need to pay for all those CPU cores? I wish I could say it's chilling in most games, but this CPU can get hot even running a browser, and I can easily notice it by increased noise from the fans. And this is while the 7800X3D from AMD performs better in most games and consumes around 80 watts compared to 280. And to handle that heat output from 14900K, be ready to spend more money on a good cooling system. It is also important to get a power supply with a larger capacity. And to handle that power consumption and CPU, do not spare money for a good motherboard. And everything I just said applies to the 13900K as well. And on the other hand, my non-gaming 13500 consumes 65 watts on a full load, with occasional turbo boost to 110 watts. It can be handled by almost any motherboard, even with a boxed cooler. Just don't cheap out on RAM and make sure that your motherboard can handle it. And you'll get a similar result, you'll save a lot of money, and if that's important for you, you can get a silent PC just like I do. I've mentioned the 7800X3D many times. In my case, I needed to stay with Intel because it handles video editing better, and my budget allowed me to keep 14900K, but it stayed in my PC for over a week, and during this time I didn't notice any difference while using it. I only noticed the noise from my cooling system, and as soon as I finished all the benchmarks, I happily replaced my 13500 back to my PC. That's not to say that I wanted to somehow mock those who told me about the bottleneck. After all, technically they are right. On the contrary, I'm glad to see the feedback. I simply wanted to show everyone else, in a more recent way, that the conversation about the weak i5 is already outdated, and it can run pretty well even with the 4090. I also realized that I can be blamed for comparing CPUs in 4K resolution. But in my humble opinion, 100 plus FPS in AAA games is already a respectable result, and I simply don't see a reason to pay more.